Greetings, everyone. 2K Sports brings you the NBA. This is Kevin Harlan along with Greg Anthony and Brett Beard. David Aldridge will be reporting from the sidelines. For the Miami Heat, they are coming off a good outing against the Rockets in Houston.
And if you look at the numbers, guys, I mean, what jumps out at you is the balance they had offensively.
Yeah, impressive total production here for a team playing in a hostile environment on the road. They looked awfully comfortable.
So Atlanta will get the first possession. So here is Miami's starting group. They've got Dragic. Whiteside is out there with Luke Babbitt. Then there's Dion Waiters. And it's Schroeder in the corner. Nailed from three-point land. Schroeder's got the first 3 points of the night up on the board for Atlanta. And so here is Miami. It's a three-point game.
Yeah, and coming into the NBA, Dennis Schroeder drew comparisons to Rajon Rondo for his frame and his quickness. He's already shown himself to be a better shooter than Rondo, but his defense still has a long way to go.
And with the offense getting right to the rim, at least they saved the layup.
And Brent, you think of the comparison between Rondo and Dennis Schroeder. They both have a certain cockiness to them, don't they?
Yeah, they play with some bravado out there, and that's one of the first things that you notice about Schroeder. Great, great confidence. He doesn't back down from the challenge that anyone offers up.
No good on that one.
Nice stroke from the line by Whiteside. You know, he's only going to get better from there with some practice.
And he's good on the second. Brent, both these teams are able to play low on the block with their back to the basket.
And how rare is that in today's game, Kevin?
Old school, you're
yeah,
right.
So yeah. We can slow down some possessions. So if you can get some easy early opportunities, 10, 12 points that way, you know that when you settle into the half court, you've got the pace, you've got the guy you want with the ball, and you can produce points.
Four on the shot clock. Measure. Off target from three-point range. And it's Miami's ball. Babbitt kicks to Whiteside. Pass to Magruder. Some nice ball movement here by the Heat. Here's Waiters. Doesn't go for him. Good D by Howard. Schroeder against Dragic with the shot. And it's Schroeder missing.
He looked like he was in rhythm to shoot that one, guys, especially as open as he was. Just clanged it.
Kicks it to Dragic. Here's Magruder. Here's Whiteside. And he gets it to go.
Well, that's a healthy make there after missing their first four shots. 1 of 5, not what they wanted, but they're on the board.
Dragic against Schroeder. Millsap dishes to Bazemore. Millsap a screen. Bazemore passes to Millsap. Nobody near Schroeder. And he's good on the three ball. Schroeder's got 6.
There, Dennis Schroeder shows some confidence by nailing the jumper.
Dragic kicks to Waiters. Let's it go from 14. Bucket is good. First quarter of ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Here's Schroeder. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against the Clippers in Los Angeles.
And what I enjoyed when watching that game was the way he balanced getting his shot and also incorporating his teammates.
And trust me, Dennis Schroeder would love to score the basketball, but his ability to set up his teammates is also effective.
Raiders against Hardaway. Here's Whiteside, and it's sent back by Howard. Outside Hardaway. Now Schroeder. 6 points for him. Screen by Howard. Schroeder kicks it to Bazemore. good on the triple. The Heat trailed by four. Down low, it's tipped. Schroeder against Dragic, and it's Dragic with the foul. That's his first foul. First quarter play, and just over 3.5 minutes in, Bazemore gets the bucket.
Jumper by Bazemore. When he's getting those kind of looks, it really does boost his confidence out on the floor.
Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Well, I was able to catch up with Eric Spoelstra a few minutes ago. On defense, he said, quote, "We're going to have to neutralize their high flyers. We can't play above the rim against these guys. Whatever it takes, we need to shut down the lane." See if they are able to do that during the game, Kevin.
Thanks, David. It's stolen by Dragic. And here's the break. Waiters gets a wide open look. Drops in the tray off the fast break. Waiters got five.
Well, some of Waiters' most efficient numbers come when he's in catch-and-shoot opportunities.
Millsap a screen. Here's Schroeder. Score of the basket is third after five shots.
Man, he's having quite the quarter, converting at a really high percentage.
Waiters with the ball. Playing Houston, he was nearly unstoppable. Dragic against Schroeder. Back to Waiters. Six to shoot. A floater, and he lays it up and in. Waiters got his third basket of the night. The Hawks leading by three. Schroeder kicks to Howard. Screen by Howard. There's the double team from Whiteside. Now here's Schroeder. He's got eight. Here's Millsap. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two. And you look at the advanced numbers. Very quietly, Paul Millsap is one of the most effective rim protectors in the league.
Yeah, I think that's pretty impressive, Kevin. And it speaks to not just the physical abilities of a player, but mentally being able to read what it is that offenses are doing and step into the right position. He's only 6'6 in socks, but when you take into account that wingspan, he can be effective down low.
First free throw is good. Both free throws good for Millsap.
There's definitely a feeling that the Hawks are building the right way around players with great character. Hard to find a selfish player in the bunch. It's the Spurs pedigree of the front office brought over by Mike Budenholzer. They understand that the culture is a big part of building a winning organization.
Dragic. Here's Magruder. And that's good. And it's Dragic with the assist.
Now, some guys have a hard time finding their teammates in those possessions. Dragic is always looking to dish to get it to the open man.
And Millsap, here we go. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game. You talk about the great chemistry of this Hawks team. You see it every time they take the court.
Well, Coach Budenholzer calls it breaking bread, making sure that the locker room has a bond and that you care a little bit about your teammates more than what they're just doing on the court. And you can certainly see the result out there on the floor. The Hawks play a very likable, team-oriented system.
Now here's Schroeder after Deion Waiters miss. Bazemore dishes to Millsap. Hardaway for three. Magruder with the rebound. The Heat trailed by four. But Trey, no good from Dragic. For Atlanta, they've gone 6-10 from the field in this ballgame. It's stolen by Dragic. Feeds to Babbitt. And that's out of bounds. Miami will retain possession. And the Heat making a change here. And Miami calls their first timeout of the game.
Dip over the past few months. He's got to get back to giving the kind of effort on the boards we were seeing from him early.
Here's Johnson. He definitely had a good game in their win against the Rockets. Schroeder against Dragic. Inside. Wants to get it back to Whiteside and does. Johnson goes in. And so many teams now make the pick and roll the real foundation of their offense.
The pick and roll game in the NBA, Kevin, is everything on offense. Whenever a possession breaks down, of course, as the shot clock winds down, you're going to find a ball handler and a screener. And some of the best in the business reside on the West Coast. I think about Chris Paul, and I think about Damian Lillard being able to operate out of those pick and rolls with great effectiveness.
Good example. Well, the Heat have had a lot of success since their inception, three titles as a team. In fact, Brent, you'd be hard-pressed to find just one great moment for a team, as they've had so many.
Well, the thing is, Kevin, they've had so many different ways in which they've constructed the team. Dwayne Wade in his prime, Shaq coming along in the later stages of his career, and then obviously having LeBron James in South Beach for a few years didn't hurt their chances of appearing in the NBA Finals. But it's the what next factor for the rest of this franchise and how quickly they can maintain Eastern Conference dominance.
And a moment now to look at the numbers for Dragic. He's averaging 20 points, 6 assists, and 4 rebounds. With him, you get so much, but his ability to lead the way with his scoring, probably his best attribute.
And the Hawks making a change here. Dunleavy's checked in, and Miami also making a switch. Ellington's checked in.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
Out of hand on it. Here's Whiteside. Gets it to go from 8 feet. Whiteside's got 5.
Well, when it comes to collecting rebounds, Hassan Whiteside is one of the best in the league. Outstanding job creating a second chance opportunity and getting the shot to go.
Atlanta with the ball. They lead by 4. Nice ball movement here by Atlanta. Dunleavy the pass to Ilyasova. 5 on the clock. A 3-pointer, no good.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
And White kicks to Johnson. Picked him clean. It's Prince on the wing. White covering. Here's Dunleavy. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Prince misses. The Heat trailed by 4. And White kicks to Johnson. That's tipped.
Ilyasova not known for his defense, but with the length he has on those arms of his, he got to the ball.
To the middle, Prince. Props in the layup for 2. Prince has got his first bucket in this one.
And their post play has been really solid right off the bat.
Johnson kicks to White. And here is Ellington. Looking at his point production, he averages almost 11 points a game. Let's it go from 11. It's deflected. Delaney is guarded by Johnson. Here's Delaney. And again, it's Atlanta.
He is just so tough to guard. He can fake you one way and then use that beautiful spin to just blow by you.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
White kicks to Johnson. The bounds, Atlanta takes possession.
And now a quick review at the numbers for Hassan Whiteside. First in rebounding, 4th in blocks, and he's in the top 10 in field goal percentage. Really able to power his way to the bucket and finish through contact.
Here's Dunleavy. Looking for his first basket still in this one. They set the pick to the middle. Here's Muscala. And the lead now, double digits on that bucket. It's a 10-point Atlanta lead.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
Due primarily to great shot selection.
Here's Johnson. The scoring numbers have been solid for him. He's averaging just under 14 points a game.
Really shocking he didn't take advantage of that golden opportunity there. He needs to be much better in that situation.
lays up the pick. Five to shoot. The Hawks need to get off a shot here. Ilyasova inside the line, and they force the shot clock violation. Great D. Already it's February. Let's see how the East is matching up. Taking a look at Atlanta. They've done well enough to be in fifth place in the conference so far. And checking out Miami, 7.5 games behind.
And you know, right now for Atlanta, this hasn't been the breakout season that many were predicting, but they're still very much in the hunt for a high postseason seed. And that will keep them focused here during the season's final stages.
Well, the goal is very defined. They have to have a strong finish to the season and make sure they get home court advantage for at least the first few rounds of the playoffs.
Now here's Prince. And for a few years now, the Heat have made a point to play at a very slow pace, helps minimize possessions for both teams. And, Brent, if you look at the roster, it plays right to their strengths.
Yeah, something about the slower pace, I think, seems to help out their current mix of players. And, of course, over the past season and a half, their development with Whiteside down there in the middle, that could slow up what you try to do offensively. But, again, a staple for Eric Spoelstra and what the Heat do is defensively causing you all sorts of trouble in the half court before it is they attack you on the other end. Well, the Hawks offense predicated on ball movement and spacing and great shooting. They keep their shooters spread all over the floor, and if they can't get layups, those catch and shoot opportunities are something they're great at.
And both free throws good for Prince. There's 1:26 left here in the opening quarter. Johnson kicks to Reed to the middle. White, good. White's got his first points in this one. And the catch and shoot jumper, statistically a better shot than pull-up, but Brent, the Hawks make it the foundation of their offense.
Yeah, even when they're driving or they're posting up, you always get the sense that they're looking for the next pass, and then potentially, Kevin, even the pass after that, the hockey assist. So you have to have a collection of good decision makers and guys confident to step up and knock down open shots.
Here's White after the basket by Atlanta. Miami needs to get a shot off. Johnson from outside sinks the three-pointer. Johnson's got it back down to single digits for Miami. Atlanta's gotten a lot of shots off from three-point land in the first quarter, but they're only 4 of 9. Prince against White, out to the right wing. Here's Muscala. And right away, they match it with a three-pointer of their own. Muscala's got his second basket of the night. Now Johnson. Read a screen. A three ball. No good on that one. And after just one quarter of play, a double dip.
Like that brings out the best in everybody on that team. They just kind of feed off of his effort and desire.
Welcome back, everyone, to Lopsided First Quarter in the books already as we start this second quarter. And, guys, we've seen the Hawks really take control here.
The roof is up right now, guys. It's raining in here. A lot of threes through the first.
And you get into that kind of zone, that's the feeling where you're invincible and it gets fun.
Bazemore is the three with Millsap before. Dennis Schroeder is out there with Tim Hardaway Jr. And it's Howard in at the center position. That's the group starting the second quarter for the Hawks. And it's slammed in by Howard.
The kind of unselfishness from Paul Millsap is why teammates really respect his play.
Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Kevin, as always, the Atlanta Hawks run that fluid offensive system that is widely admired. You know, Steve Kerr, our old friend, used to say, they get to the next level of their offense. You take away the first option, they automatically get to the second. You take that one, they automatically and fluidly get to the third option. And very few teams do that. Kevin?
Passing and shooting, D.A., that's what it's all about. Thank you.
Yeah, thought process was after he hit that first three, he'd be in great shape, but he looks way off right now.
Millsap a screen on Johnson. Back to Bazemore. Three-pointer. The shot's good on the assist by Schroeder. Bazemore's got five.
Well, once Bazemore gets the ball off the pass, he immediately skies up for the jump shot and nails it. You like to see that kind of assertive, aggressive, confident attitude.
Now here's Waiters. He's got seven. And again, it's the Heat missing.
And you know what? He's just not on his game, no doubt about it. Their deficit isn't totally on him, but he has not been an asset for his team.
Here's Schroeder. 17-point lead, their biggest. Fades and shoots. And he overshot that one, missing.
Well, the defense was right up on him, so electing to go for the fadeaway there to create some room, well, that makes sense.
Waiters with the ball. He's been a factor in their offense on most nights with his scoring average at nearly 16 points a game. Now here's Dragic. And it's sent back by Howard.
And love seeing Howard rise up and reject shooters. Just a juggernaut on defense.
Just claimed that possession for his own there. Grabs the offensive rebound and puts it right back in.
Whiteside's checked in for the Heat. Miami shooting their fifth free throw of the game here. Reed no good on the free throw. As the NBA, Brent, becomes more and more of a skill game where versatility is so valuable, you certainly fit that description as a player. Do you like the way the game is going in that regard?
I do like it, Kevin, and I'll return a question to you and ask you if you think that the skills of the players are just more honed than they were maybe 25, 30 years ago because of their availability to these specialized coaches. This was not the way it was for that generation of players.
Excellent point, but have the rules even enhanced it more that players can show more of their skills now?
Yeah, there's no question about it that the league has tended to go towards being able to allow guys freedom of movement, off-ball movement. The flow of the game is much better. The three-point shot, as we talked about at length, has opened up the floor, and you get to see the grace and athleticism of some of the game's best.
The Heat making a switch here. Atlanta leading by 15. Now here's Schroeder. 8 points for him. Howard in the post. He's covered by Whiteside. Here's Millsap, and he didn't get quite enough under that one.
And being that close to the hoop, I thought he had enough room to finish that one.
There we go. Whiteside kicks to Waiters. And it's good from the elbow. Waiters got 9 points.
Some people feel Waiters takes too many contested jumpers, and that lowers his field goal percentage, but he nails that one.
Here's Bazemore. 5 points in the game. Passes it to Schroeder. Howard with a screen on Dragic. Back to Bazemore. Front pass the arc. And it's Miami with the rebound. Whiteside's got the glass covered here tonight. 11 boards for him. Now here's Dragic. He picked up 21 points in their last win against Houston.
Felt like he had a sense in that game that the defense was being over-aggressive, and he tried to take advantage of that. He continually frustrated them throughout the night and got to the free throw line.
Yeah, those are starting to add up, guys. Up their last five baskets, three have been tripled.
Raiders again, Hardaway. Here's Dragic. Finally gets one to fall. He's now 1 for 5 with his first make.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Dragic against Schroeder. Pass to Millsap. Hardaway kicks to Howard. Oh, and it looks like that's going to be a goaltending call. Yep, that's it. So they'll get the basket.
He thought he had the clean block there, but the refs saw it differently, and they call the goaltend.
The Atlanta Hawks come into this one following a loss to the Clippers in Los Angeles.
Yeah, major problems at the charity stripe in that game. They just could not convert their free throws.
When you're on the road, those are not points that you can afford to miss out on. Step up, knock down your free throws. They shot themselves in the foot with their struggles at the line.
No doubt the fight's there. They are trying to battle back, but he's just really struggling this quarter.
Hardaway with the steal. To the paint. Wants to get it to Bazemore and does. Shoot from the right block. He dishes it to Millsap. Parked down low that time, and he got the three-second goal. Block shots, a stat that sometimes doesn't tell the whole story. Big-time shot blockers aren't always elite defenders. And then the opposite is true. Their block shot totals don't quite capture that great impact they really have defensively.
You know, and Hakeem the Dream, certainly one of the greatest all-around players to have ever played the game. An endless array of offensive moves down low, no doubt. And defensively, his numbers speak for themselves. I mean, almost 4,000 career blocks, 2 Defensive Player of the Year awards, just a legendary low-post defender.
I mean, the guy just flat-out competes, incredibly aggressive on the offensive glass and the stick back.
The pass to Bazemore. The feed to Howard. Off the left rim and out.
Well, it looked like he was hesitating on that one, guys. Have no clue why, though.
And here's Dragic. Looking at the numbers, he's averaging about 20 and a half points a game. Right side of screen. Clock at 6. Dragic dishes to Whiteside. And the jam by Whiteside.
Well, I would say that's as high percentage as you're going to get from Hassan Whiteside. He really takes off on those dunks.
Hardaway kicks it over to Schroeder. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2. And this is where you start to see the wear and tear of the season take its toll, Brent. Players start getting tired legs, and little injuries begin to crop up.
And this is where opportunities for guys who are a little bit deeper on the bench may crop up. And so the coach's job is to make sure that their confidence is there, that they're ready to go. And when called upon as a player, you're ready to deliver.
That's a good answer. And the first one drops.
I just can't help but think of what Miami was able to accomplish with the big 3. 4 straight NBA Finals appearances. That hadn't happened in the NBA for almost 30 years.
Here's what Miami's going with right now. Whitey's checked in for Luke Babbitt. Ellington comes in for Waiters. And it's Johnson in for Goran Dragic. Schroeder hits them both. And Bray, you talked about the Heat making 4 consecutive finals. Historically speaking, that's actually a more unusual feat than winning 3 straight titles.
Yeah, I think they'd rather have the 3 rings, but you have to give them a ton of credit for the way they set up the basketball team. And now it's moving forward in the absence of LeBron James to see where they can get to and how quickly to become an Eastern Conference power once again.
Now here's Prince. Delaney, Ellington defending. Now the dish to Prince. And once again off the mark by Atlanta. The Heat trailed by 14. Ellington kicks to White. He goes up again. And Whiteside finishes it off. Whiteside's got 6 points in the quarter.
His shooting percentage is really outstanding tonight, and his team has needed it big time.
And Muscala kicks to Prince. And it's Schroeder in the corner. He feeds it to Ilyasova. Dishes it to Muscala. Schroeder with the ball. And it's Johnson picking him up. And it's Schroeder missing. And Miami shooting poorly, just 35% so far. Johnson, the pass to Ellington. Here's Magruder. Good ball movement here by Miami. White dishes to Johnson. He kicks it to Ellington. Johnson with a screen on Schroeder. Poked loose. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Schroeder. These players have been dominant on the glass in their last 10 games, leading the NBA in rebounding. Hassan Whiteside on top. In the third spot, Dwight Howard.
The work this twosome has done on the boards over that period cannot be overlooked. They've both been big factors.
Off the inbound, Johnson can't hit. The Hawks leading by 12. Inside, the kick out to Ilyasova. Now Schroeder, 10 points for him. Pass to Muscala, just 5 to shoot. The shot's good on the assist by Schroeder. Schroeder's got 4 assists now tonight.
And that's why Schroeder has a spot in the rotation. Coach recognizes his passing ability. He sets up his teammates well.
Here's Magruder. An 11-point game for him in the win against Houston. Johnson kicks to White. Johnson outside. Trying his luck deep. Rebound, Atlanta. The Heat beat them last time when these two teams met down in South Florida.
And no doubt that the fight was there, but no matter what they tried on that night, it just wasn't meant to be.
And their troubles just seemed to get compounded as they got later into that game. They did not have it that night whatsoever, and it ended up being a double-digit loss.
And here's Ilyasova outside. Another three for Atlanta.
Yeah, they're 6 points on consecutive three balls. They're finding holes now in the D.
Pass to Magruder. Johnson the screen. Whiteside with it. A 23-point game for him in the win against the Rockets in Houston.
And, of course, you cannot forget just how dominant his shot blocking was in that game. Just changed the entire complexion of that game.
Hard to believe that Hassan Whiteside wasn't even in the NBA a few seasons ago, Brent. Took some time off, but what a find he has been since coming back into the league.
Well, it's been nice to see him re-engage and maybe turn around his attitude and work ethic and maybe wanting this at his size. You have to give credit to Whiteside for not giving up on himself and putting some of that work in to become the player he is right now.
Dunleavy's check in for Dennis Schroeder. Johnson, he's checked in for the Heat. Good on both.
I mean, there's no doubt that every offense thinks about Hassan Whiteside and what he can do to you on the defensive end of the floor. He bothers so many shots with his height and his length. His timing to go up and swat shots away is just unprecedented. Nice to have a big man in the league that does things like that on that end of the floor.
Back to Ilyasova. Another miss by Ilyasova.
And one thing I liked in the first quarter was their aggressiveness to draw the contact, putting the defense on the defensive.
Whiteside, the pass to Ellington. Whiteside, White. Johnson kicks to Whiteside. And it's good off the back of the rim and in. Whiteside's got 15. And thinking again on Whiteside, Brent, that is what sticks out to me. His ability to time up blocks with his height is something you very rarely see.
Well, the one thing, Kevin, he does so well is the long arms. He keeps them down and then extends them as quick as possible to get to the ball. And I think that offensive players don't realize he's got a chance to get to him. That's why he's one of the league leaders in block shots. Fantastic team defensive effort there. They made him uncomfortable taking that inside look, and it showed in the release.
Now here's Johnson. Right side a screen. Kicks it out to Johnson. From downtown. Rebound by Muscala. Muscala's got 3 rebounds now in this one. 5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Delaney, he's guarded by Johnson. There's the call on James Johnson. That is his first foul of the game.
I mean, that's a tough break for the D. I mean, he took the hit and drew the whistle.
There's 14 seconds left in the first half. Prince outside. Out to the right wing. Pocket 4. For 3, Dunleavy. That shot, no good. The clock runs out, and we're heading to halftime. The Heat trailed by 14. Our second half of basketball and presented by Gatorade. Let's see who's all fueled up and on the floor to start the third. On the court for the Heat, Whiteside is out there with Luke Babbitt. Then there's Krogic. Then there's Deion Waiters. And Hardaway gets it to go.
Haven't we seen that a few times today, guys? I mean, their defense has got to have a little bit more toughness about it.
Krogic dishes to Waiters. To the left side wing. Krogic against Schroeder. Clock is at 3. Got a piece of it. Here's Magruder. And they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation.
And so much more responsibility for Hawks head coach Mike Budenholzer, named the team president in the summer of 2015. But I'll tell you what, he's been well prepared. 18 years in San Antonio, actually played for Coach Popovich during those days where he was an athlete. He'll tell you he still is one, but he's doing a terrific job.
Right side against Howard. Back to Schroeder. Pulls up a screen. And it's out of bounds to the Hawks as Atlanta retains possession. And we take a look here at the shot chart.
Well, they haven't really been strong enough inside. I mean, they haven't been a force or aggressive with getting those good quality looks in the paint. And I think the one-dimensionality of their offense is going to continue to be an issue because the defense isn't having to worry about clogging the lane or defending down low.
And if you're just joining us, we played over a minute here in the third. Just 2 to shoot.
And if you have credits to give out, give them to Dragic. Stellar defense.
Schroeder against Dragic. Outside Hardaway. Howard in the post. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot 2. When you think of the temperament of Mike Budenholzer, comparing him to, say, Greg Popovich, who he was an assistant coach under for well over a decade, Brent, how would you compare the two of them?
They're very charismatic. They're the kind of coaches that, as players, once you get some time with them, get a chance to know them, that what they're trying to do is just get the best out of you. That's something that both of them share.
And he can't get the first one.
And the former first overall pick in the 04 draft, Howard has had a stellar career, a dominant force who continues to frustrate the opposition.
And he misses the second one as well, so he is 0 for 2 that time. Well, you look around the NBA, so much turnover in the coaching ranks. I think I read that since the end, Brent, of the 2012-13 season, only about 6 or 7 coaches have remained with the same team. It's a tough, tough job.
It's a very difficult business, Kevin, and I think a lot of the younger ownership groups, and we've had a lot of ownership changeover as well,
you sure have,
are not willing to be as patient with the coaching staffs that they put in place, and that doesn't allow guys to develop in the same system over and over. I always think about DeMarcus Cousins in the first few years in Sacramento, seeing 5 or 6 different coaches for him and having to learn a new way to play each time a coach comes in and moving him around the system. It's very hard to find consistency, not only with a team, but with an individual player because of so much changeover.
You sometimes see more patience in other sports. That doesn't seem to be the case in the NBA.
And I think one of the reasons why in the NBA, Kevin, is, you know this, 2 or 3 guys can make the difference between a team that's not competitive and then all of a sudden flip the switch to becoming a playoff caliber team. So it has to do with the personnel. In the NBA, players can make all the difference.
Good point. Now here's Dragic following the miss by Paul Millsap. Dragic kicks to Whiteside. They need this one. Great D that time from Howard.
Well, he's a great finisher around the rim, but some stellar defense there stopped that from happening.
He's more for 3. Rebound by the Heat. Whiteside's got his 18th rebound here tonight, all over the place. Back to Dragic. Pass to Magruder. Some nice ball movement here by the Heat. And Waiters kicks to Whiteside. Fader on the way, and he can't bank that one in. now. Here's Bazemore. He's tightly guarded. Here's Schroeder. The Hawks again can't hit.
Well, sometimes when you're that wide open, you start to overthink it, and it looks like that's what he did there.
Back to Dragic. Kicks to Babbitt. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. Paul Millsap picks one up. The Heat have converted 4 of 7 free throws on the night.
And the season numbers for them at the line thus far are really poor. Something I'm sure they are making a point of emphasis.
And the Hawks, Brent, going with the brand revamp. Throwback logo, new uniforms. How do you like the new look?
Yeah, they're not bad. I don't like when they mismatch the jerseys, Kevin. You know, they'll do the red on the bottom with the charcoal gray on top. I get a little bit confused. I'm more of a traditionalist that way, but we haven't seen a lot of neon in the NBA, but the Hawks bringing it in. And I also, Kevin, like the way that some of the franchises recently have gone to the new almost soccer circular logo. So I like the way Atlanta has situated themselves with that sort of styling.
Now here's Schroeder. He's got 12. Feeds it to Bazemore. Now here's Schroeder. Millsap a screen. Hardaway for three. The shot's good on the assist by Schroeder. Schroeder's got 6 assists here tonight. The Heat trailed by 19.
Timeout.
The Heat call time here.
Started.
And Dragic has it in the corner. Pass to Magruder. Dragic against Schroeder. 6 on the shot clock. Now here's Waiters, guarded by Hardaway. The kick out to Dragic. Here's Magruder. Here's Waiters. 9 points in the game so far. Babbitt, good.
Great job of screening there. Nice job to take it to the rim and get the finish.
And here is Hardaway. Here's Schroeder. There's 3-pointers off the mark. The Heat trail by 17. He gets a chance now to catch up with the 4th member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, Chris Humphries was first one of the best rebounders in the league, and now, after a few years of tinkering with a jumper, he's become a pretty good shooting big man. After the 2015 playoffs, Wizards coach Randy Whitman suggested that Humphries work on his 3-pointer. Humphries said, "I hadn't really worked on it ever. I just had to adapt. I went at it trying to expand my game so I can play longer." Kevin?
I'm sure we'll see a lot of players trying to add that 3, D.A. Thank you.
Well, you have to talk about Paul Millsap with glowing remarks to his skill set. It's one of the most skilled power forwards the NBA has, and you look up and down the stat sheet, he'll do it all. He'll block and steal and rebound and have assists. And oh, by the way, now able to stretch the floor out as a 3-point shooter.
And the Heat making a change here. Johnson's checked in. And he can't hit the second. And Millsap, since moving to the Eastern Conference, Brent, finally enjoying the recognition he deserves.
Yeah, a multiple-time All-Star, and he just keeps getting better. Even as he enters his 30s, Paul Millsap puts up impressive statistics.
The Heat trailed by 18. Passes to Babbitt. Pass to Dragic. He dishes it to Whiteside. That's in, coming off an assist from Dragic. Dragic has got 3 assists now in this one.
You can't allow Whiteside to get the basketball inside the paint like that. He is lights out from that close.
Now here is Hardaway. He's got 8. Howard with a screen on Dragic. To the inside. And again, it's Paul Millsap. Millsap's got 8 points.
And an open path to to the hoop there. Easy bucket. We've seen that far too many times today.
And knowing that's the kind of D the opposition has been playing, he's going straight for the jugular, just like he should.
Babbitt passes to Whiteside. Good ball movement here by the Heat. Dragic, beautiful dish, and the layup goes down.
Well, getting the ball off the dribble to the bucket is one of Dragic's strengths. You can't afford to let him get that close to the rim, or he's going to get you.
Now here is Hardaway. He's been a reliable scorer for him as he's averaging up over 13 points a game. Schroeder with the ball, and it's Johnson picking him up.
Come on, shoot!
Now here's Bazemore. He's guarded closely. Out of bounds. Miami takes possession.
Taking a look here at the numbers for Schroeder. His last 10 games, averaging about 16 points, 6 assists, and 2 rebounds. And he's really been pulling his weight. He's had a hand in some big plays here recently.
The Heat trail by 16. And Waiters kicks to Babbitt. Now Whiteside. He's got 18. And the pass to Waiters. Back to Whiteside. That's a basket. His 8th from the field. 8 of 14.
Again and again, they're dissecting
timeout.
The defense and creating those hyper.
The feed to Muscala. There's the dish to Ilyasova. Prince outside. The Hawks again can't hit. The Heat trail by 14. Here's White. And he gets that one to go off the front iron.
I know the difficulty degree there high, but he drains it.
Dishes it to Ilyasova. Prince outside. Here's Delaney. Loses the defender with the screen and drills the jumper. 6 points for him. So it's Miami now. Johnson kicks to White. To the left side wing. Now here's Ellington. Defended by Dunleavy. To the paint. Here's Reed. Got a hand on it. Here's Ilyasova, and he makes that one. Ilyasova's got 8 points.
It's nice to see the confidence he shows on his inside game and ability to get the shot up before the defender can do anything.
Johnson the screen. Johnson outside. 3-pointer Ellington. It's rebounded by Ilyasova. Delaney, who's guarded by Johnson. Back to Ilyasova. Dunleavy dishes to Ilyasova. Clock at 6. Kicks to Dunleavy. He feeds it to Ilyasova. Here's Delaney. And a miss there on the triple. The Heat trailed by 16. Johnson with it. To the middle. Here's Ellington, and it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
And taking a look now at the stats for Johnson. Some nice work from him over the last 10 games. 7th in blocks, and with a top 20 ranking in field goal percentage, you put the ball in his hands, and he converts at a remarkable rate.
And that one falls for Ellington. And the Hawks 2 seasons ago storming to 60 wins and Brent the #1 seed in the Eastern Conference. And along the way, a franchise best 19-game winning streak.
Well, how amazing was that month of January where they played perfect basketball? The starting 5, they were all named co-players of the month. That was a first in league history. Also the franchise's first time to the conference finals in that season. But after getting swept, you know they still have some work to do.
Now here's Prince. The 10-footer. And White with the block. White against Prince. Muscala, the pass to Prince. From outside the arc. Some solid defense from Reed. The Heat trailed by 14. Kept alive. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
And one of the problems in the first half, that shoddy work at the free throw line. They needed to fix that, and they've been much improved since the break.
Well, you look at the Miami Heat, and there's a lot of experience on that roster. But you know, Brent, even the role players who have been in this league for a while, well, they've carved out nice roles for the team as well.
Yeah, you can never underestimate what it's like to have experience in the NBA, not only in dealing with training camp and a new coach, but the length of a season, and then potentially, if those things all come together, a nice long playoff run. They play a very controlled style, and Eric Spoelstra has the team pointed in the right direction. Great to see young players like Winslow getting some early important minutes for his career.
Feeds it to Ilyasova. He kicks it to Prince. There's a screen. Here's Delaney. And it's Miami with the rebound. White's got three rebounds so far in the game. A nice shot by Reed. James Johnson. 106 left in the third quarter of the game. Prince outside. Hawks passing it around. Pass to Dunleavy. To the inside. Delaney. And he drops in the layup off the glass. 8 points for him.
Man, his shot on target, guys. They have the lead right now primarily because of his effort.
Johnson outside. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
I'll tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
And he knocks down the first one.
Well, you look at head coach Eric Spoelstra, the first word that comes to mind is meticulous. He started at the bottom. Now he's here. He used to fetch laundry and walk the coach's dogs. Not doing that anymore. Now one of the most respected coaches in the league. To see how far he's come from the film room to the hardwood, you just have to credit remarkable work ethic.
And Johnson drops them both. And you remember when Eric Spoelstra was the young, unproven coach directing the Big Three, and Brent, believe it or not, he's now the longest tenured coach in the Eastern Conference.
You know, the amazing thing, Kevin, he's still got a good full head of hair. Still that jet black hair. When is that going to turn gray? I guess if you win some championships and you have that kind of success, it's not going anywhere. And neither is Eric Spoelstra.
Ilyasova can't hit. Ellington kicks to Johnson. Passes it to Ellington. No good. Well, through three quarters of play, down to energy, asking his guys to mount an attack.
Well, and all five guys need to be on the same page. You need to be active, yes, but you also really need to communicate with one another.
And the final period of play just about to start. Bazemore is the three with Millsap the four. Hardaway is out there with Dennis Schroeder. And it's Howard in at the five, down low. So that's the lineup for Atlanta. The Heat trailed by 12. Johnson outside. Johnson the screen. And Dragic gets it to go on the assist by Johnson. 6 points for Goran Dragic.
I think that's exactly the shot they wanted, Kevin. He can make that one all day long.
Millsap sets the pick for Schroeder. Pass to Bazemore. Millsap a screen on Waiters. Screen by Howard. Bazemore for three. The shot, no good. And Miami the other way now. Dragic kicks to Waiters. Back to Dragic. He dishes it to Waiters. Got a piece of it. Six on the shot clock. Fires the three. Rebound, Atlanta. Millsap's got rebound number five here tonight.
Well, the D looks like they're laying off just a little bit. He made one three in the first half, but they're still daring him to shoot, and he can't make them pay for it.
Oh, tough D on the inside.
That's really one of his specialties, altering shots in close.
Johnson against Hardaway. Johnson dishes to Waiters. Johnson sends the screen for Dragic. Here's Reed. Offline with his three. The Hawks leading by 10. And it's Schroeder in the corner. Hardaway for three. And it's Miami with the rebound. Now here's Dragic. Waiters with the ball. He's picked up by Millsap. Up again. It's good on the putback. Johnson's got it back down to a single-digit deficit for the Heat.
And those second-chance points really become almost like bonus points when you can get them.
Howard with a screen on Johnson. Hardaway passes to Schroeder. It's Howard, top of the key. Millsap kicks it to Bazemore. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it three.
And can you always depend on him or what to lead you to the right place with that pass? Money.
A different look for Miami. Whiteside's checked in for Willie Reed. And it's Luke Babbitt in for Johnson. And the free throw, no good. And Brent, you look at Kent Bazemore, undrafted out of Old Dominion. At first, he was known more for his sideline antics as a reserve for the Warriors than anything else.
Well, now he's got other guys on the sideline waving towels, Kevin. He's developed into a very valuable rotation player, and he still plays with a chip on his shoulder, and I think that really helps him.
Haters, no luck.
Well, that's a shot right there. He's going to hit 9 times out of 10. We just saw the 10% he doesn't make.
Howard dishes to Schroeder. Outside Hardaway. To the middle. Here's Millsap. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
And Dwight Howard, you know, he's lost some explosiveness over the years, but still remains an intimidating presence when he's healthy. I mean, I wouldn't necessarily call him a number one option on the offensive end, but still great in the pick and roll, better than most when it comes to posting. And defensively, when he's moving well, a straight beast.
No good on that one. And talking about Howard's defense, he's blocking fewer shots these days, but he remains extremely difficult to score against in the paint.
Yeah, statistically, opponents still struggle to shoot against him. He has the power and instincts to stop most true centers from getting comfortable on the blocks, and his reputation goes a long way toward unnerving opponents.
And he sinks the second. And business, obviously, is great in the NBA. Player salaries shooting up. Franchise values skyrocketing. In fact, Brent, I saw the other day a new study saying the average team is now worth over $1 billion. Some much more than that. You still want to own a team someday? Can you afford that?
Yeah, I don't think that's going to happen anytime soon, Kevin. But our game is in a great place. And one of the things that makes me most proud as a former player, Kevin, is who it is that represents the NBA right now in terms of their character, in terms of their class, in terms of some of the stances that they take, even outside of the sport, getting involved in politics, getting involved in their local community. The league continues to do amazing things both on and off the court.
I would say maybe never been healthier than it is right now on all fronts. The way it's played, the name stars, the community activism, all of it.
I agree with you, Kevin.
Now here's Dragic. It's good from long range. Babbitt's got 9 points now in just the second half.
A wonderful look from Dragic, who nicely set up one of his guys for a great look.
Shooter passes to Millsap. Soft touch off the glass. sets, got 5 points in the quarter.
Wow, has he flipped a switch at halftime. Much more effective here in the second half.
They set the pick. Here's Waiters. Good work defensively by Millsap.
It's just been a frustrating day for him all the way around, and it's rubbed off now, I think, on the rest of the team.
Hardaway kicks to Millsap. Schroeder dishes to Hardaway. Nice ball movement here by Atlanta. That's 3-pointers off the mark.
Really surprising to see the huge edge they have in rebounds, given what the scoreboard says.
Babbitt, good.
Love to see passes to guys on the move that are on target. They don't break stride.
Outside Hardaway. Screen by Howard. Hardaway passes to Schroeder. Just 5 on the clock. Hardaway for 3. The shot's good on the assist by Schroeder. Schroeder's got 9 assists in the game. Great passing. The Heat trail by 9. Outside Dragic. The pass to Whiteside. Count it. And with that basket, he's now 9 of 15 from the floor.
Well, sending out the memo to the team. Get Whiteside the rock. Everything he's touching right now is going in.
Howard with a screen on Dragic. Outside Millsap. Gets the 3-pointer to fall. And the Hawks lead by 10.
And what a turnaround from the first half. I mean, he's been incredible here in the second half.
Outside Dragic. And it's Waiters at the elbow. Shoots from the baseline. Here's Whiteside. He gets it in there.
Aggressive rebounding from Whiteside there. No one is going to contest those.
The Hawks leading by 7. And Bazemore kicks to Howard. Here's Bazemore. The feed to Millsap. Screen by Howard. And it's slammed in by Millsap.
Well, right now, Millsap is the guy you need to feed. He's knocking down everything out there.
Outside Dragic. Side a screen, pass to Magruder, and it goes out of bounds. Went off Dragic.
And that's just carelessness there. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
That has gone 2 of 5 on 3-point shots since the end of the third quarter. Schroeder kicks to Howard. Back to Schroeder. Millsap a screen to the right side. Double team on Millsap. Stolen by Waiters. And it's the Heat on the break. The dish to Dragic. It's stolen by Schroeder. One-on-one here. Puts one up from 19. They get it again. And here is Howard. This is the Bazemore. He feeds it to Schroeder. Millsap sets the pick for Schroeder. Goes up again. Howard dishes to Schroeder. Good on the shot. And now an 11-point Hawks lead.
And good passing setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Side inside, working on Howard. And 2 shots coming up at the line as he gets fouled on the shot.
Well, nice work on the interior from Whiteside there. His free throw game is a work in progress.
The first free throw is good. One falls, so he hits both of them. Here's Schroeder. They set the screen. Kicks it to Millsap. Foul called that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
And really, Millsap is a very reliable free throw shooter. Sending him to the line, not maybe in your team's best interest.
The first one falls. And so Paul Millsap nails both of them. The Heat trail by 11. Now Dragic feeds it to Babbitt. Pass to Magruder. Shot from 12. No good on the shot. And Atlanta will come the other way. Earlier in the game, they had a 19-point lead. They get to take on the Magic at Orlando after this one. And that'll be the first of a two-game road trip for them. Miami's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. And Waiters kicks to Dragic. Passes it to Babbitt. Millsap with the steal. Dragic against Schroeder. Out to the wing. He kicks to Hardaway. Pass to Bazemore. Shot clock at 6. He dishes it to Schroeder. Fires from deep. And it's Hassan Whiteside with the rebound. The Heat trailed by 13. Pass to Magruder, and their feet to Waiters. Here's the screen. Dragic kicks to Whiteside. That's it, coming off an assist from Dragic. That's 29 points for Hassan Whiteside.
I tell you what a good thing that he showed up today, because without him, this thing would already be over.
Millsap a screen. Schroeder kicks it to Bazemore. Good on the three-point shot. And the Hawks lead by 14.
And that's just a pretty-looking stroke from the outside by Bazemore there. The perimeter shot now a staple of his game.
That's it, 5 from 18. And the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim. Schroeder's got 6 in the quarter.
And a really nice 1-2 punch there, guys. Great defensive play and great basket in transition.
Exactly what can happen when you're careless with the basketball. Suddenly, it's going the other way.
Heat moving the ball around. Here's Dragic. Second shot opportunity. And it's laid in by Whiteside. Whiteside's got 31 points.
I mean, he is just demoralizing his opponent right now on the backcourt. They didn't want anything to do with him on that possession. Almost like they were just giving up on the play.
Well, we saw the same kind of attack in the last game. Ferocious effort in back-to-back outings.
Here's Millsap, and it's Whiteside with the rebound. The Heat trail by 14.
And clearly, we will not be witnessing a spirited comeback tonight, albeit as exciting as that would be. This was an excellent all-around performance for the Hawks.
Tonight, they did a great job of getting everyone involved. They had the good passing, and that led to some open shots.
Solid play, definitely, Kevin.
And with this win, they'll end up notching another victory for this year's campaign, win number 33.
And on the season, this is going to be their third win in 4 games against this team. And a great team effort, but still, what an individual performance
for Schroeder.
Look, tonight as a player, he was exactly the kind of guy you want to suit up with. A total team-first attitude, kept the offense flowing, some great passes, some great assists, and even more high fives. Great job tonight.
So neither attempt will fall that time for him. Atlanta with the ball. It's a 14-point game. Howard with it. He's picked up by Whiteside. And Howard, here we go. And Whiteside sends it back.
As soon as Whiteside positions himself, he just spikes that one away. It's like he's playing beach volleyball.
Babbitt, good.
The offense has clearly kicked into gear. The question, though, is it just a little too late?
Definitely too late. The time to rally was when the game was in the balance. Now you're just creating highlight reels.
Now here's Millsap. Millsap a screen. Bazemore passes to Millsap. The pass to Schroeder. In the corner, Hardaway with it. Schroeder with the ball. And so it's the Hawks taking care of business in this one. Some good moments throughout this one, but they had the clear advantage down the stretch.
Yeah, I mean, I love the way they execute.
Schroeder, in my opinion, his passing is what really drove them to this win. He did a fantastic job of spreading the ball around and keeping everyone involved in the offense. And he wound up with a nice number of assists to show for it.
Listen, he didn't let him down. He came through with a fantastic performance. That's showing some character at a critical time. This was the game.